shared this presentation with my colleagues, Angelija Bučienė. She is close to me, yes. And Erika Čepienė also joined, I see, in this conference. So, we will talk about Lithuania again, and we will talk about a very specific topic in Lithuania about depopulation in rural areas, but in very specific rural areas, in regional parks, and about depopulation in regional parks. And for us, it was very interesting. Do regional parks stabilize the situation or not? And what mean this, and we will explain. What is the situation now in Lithuania, but not only in Lithuania, when we're talking about depopulation? This process is going in many countries, especially in Eastern Europe, in former Soviet Union countries, and in Lithuania also. And the depopulation process were accelerated, especially after the Soviet Union collapsed in 1991. Why number of population decreasing? We have many reasons, social, economic, political, cultural traditions, etc. Many reasons. And many population not living now in rural areas, and happy that situation become more worse now. When we're talking about regional park, it's very important to say that in Lithuania we have 30 regional parks, and they of course have many of tasks and functions, but the main function is to preserve the physical and cultural components, landscapes, also cultural heritage, Natura 2000 habitats, and etc. When we're talking about Lithuanian case, and especially when we're analyzing our regional parks, for us it was very interesting situation that number of population in territories of regional park maybe will be much less comparing with another areas in Lithuania, for example. Why? Because people, especially young people, now we have tendency that starting to go to surrounding areas of cities, of urban areas, and maybe they want to work in harmony with nature. So in our research, we will analyze three regional parks in western part of Lithuania. Also, we will analyze the changing of settlements, especially disappeared settlements, and settlements which are going to be disappeared, where number of population is less than 5. So shortly, where these three parks are situated. As you see, these parks are in western part of Lithuania, and they have the common object, their water. But one park situated near to the Baltic Sea is the smallest park by number of population and by area. Next park, Nemuno Delta, situated near between Curonian Lagoon and Nemunas River. And the last Salantai Regional Park have many rivers and many lakes, and this the most agrarian regional park between them. And as you see, they have a very different number of settlements, of area, and number of population. So we used many methods. I will name some methods as a compilation of different scientific sources and different legal documents, analysis of population census data, and also to compare the situation, we used statistical data of 2019. Also to make some grouping of rural settlements by functional priority. Also we analyzing historical and cultural and also conservational functional material. We using GIS mapping and also semi-structural interview methods in 11 wards. And we talked and we got the answers from administration of wards in this area. Very shortly, what is situation now in Lithuania in point of view settlements? So in Lithuania, medium village size is dominating, but number of villages is decreasing. And for example, if we're talking about settlements with zero population, the number of such settlements increased more about twice since 1989 till 2011. And in western part, in Klaipeda County, where our regional park situated, population without settlements without population increased by 12 settlements. So for us, it was also very interesting the special priorities in regional parks, because in settlements we can find the priorities of conservation interests, recreation interests, and also other priorities like ecological protection, urban and economic development. Here we can see that we have in regional parks very different settlements, as I told, mostly villages are very small. We have four townships and one small town, but mostly they are villages. In the regional park now, now we have three settlements without population and seven settlements where number of population is four and less. And here in this map you can see all regional parks. This map show for us very clearly the changing of population in settlements. It's very important to say that only in townships the population exceeds more than 1,000 inhabitants. Number in mostly settlements, number of population in mostly settlements, as you see, is decreasing. We have negative change of population, especially in Salantai and Nemunas Delta. For example, in Nemunas Delta Regional Park, number of population decreased by also 25% since 2001. In Salantai Regional Park, almost 20%. and only in Pajūris Regional Park because it's very, very attractive for population, because situated near the Baltic Sea, between Klaipeda port city and between Palanga resort. So it's very attractive regional park, and in this park we can observing positive changing of population. When we are talking about priority interests, also the situation the same in point of view, Pajūris Regional Park in all zones, number of population is increasing. In another regional park, in all zones, number of population are increasing. And it's very important to say that conservation interests not necessarily influencing the number of population. So why number of population are decreasing in mostly of settlements? So we found some common reasons as lack of job, as a lack of social skills, using of alcohol, aging of population, but their reasons are common for all Lithuanian places, rural places, but specific reasons for regional park are limited agricultural activities, lack of collaboration between local communities and regional parks, and also lack of ecological education for local people. And conclusions. When we're talking about all regional parks, very small settlements are dominating, but in the same settlements, young people are coming here, they want to live here, but especially very attractive settlements where social infrastructure are developed in these places only. As I told, Pajūris Regional Park is very unique, is very attractive comparing with another parks. In period since 2001 till 2019, number of population in Pajūris Regional Park increased more than 3 times. But in regional parks, we observing some conflicts because between local population and regional park administration, because many laws and we have very strict laws who limit development of settlements in all parks, especially in Pajūris Regional Park. When we're talking about another parks, about Nemunas Delta Regional Park is a very specific park because it's every year is flooded by Nemunas River, and we have many flooded meadows, and the farmers there can develop only limited farming, livestock farming in this area. And people have possibility only to develop recreational services. And for us, it's very important to have more collaborations between local people, between administration of a regional park to make common projects, to make some events, different arts, because still now
2 minutes.
Yes, we have some problems. So thank you for attention. You can see here in the picture very interesting place in Lithuania, Pajūris Regional Park, the Dutch hat. Please visit this place if you will be here in Lithuania.